ओके, कमिंग फॉर द नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम फॉर कैपेसिटर कैपेसिटेंस चैप्टर, व्हाट इज डिस्कस्ड हियर, टू कैपेसिटर C1 एंड C2 आर चार्ज टू 120 वोल्ट एंड 200 वोल्ट रेस्पेक्टिवली। इट इज फाउंड दैट बाय कनेक्टिंग देम टुगेदर, मींस आइदर बाय सीरीज और पैरेलल दे आर कनेक्टेड टुगेदर, द पोटेंशियल ऑन ईच ऑफ वन ऑफ देम इज जीरो। देन इफ इट इज होल्ड, मींस potential in each of them is zero, then calculate the relation between C1 and C2. So let's do that. So first of all, what is happening? If I am having two capacitors, so when the potential made to be zero, see the potential on each one of them can be made zero if and only if they are connected in opposite polarity. These things made very clear. See, one thing is one capacitor connected to 120 volt and another is 200 volt. So there is only one condition when the capacitance after connection, voltage after connection may be zero, if they are connected in opposite polarity. Basically what is happening, that one terminal completed, then another terminal of the capacitor start. So here what we are doing, that positive terminal connected to the negative terminal of the capacitor and next negative terminal connected to the positive terminal of the capacitors. So it can be possible that potential on each of them are zero. So and common potential due to their redistribution of the charge is what? The total charge by total capacitance. So let's do that. So let's C1 is this side positively charged and this side negatively charged. Similarly, I am taking C2, this side positively charged, this side negatively charged. Okay, so I am connecting what? I need potential zero. So potential zero means what? These two terminals, this side will be connected to this and this side will be connected to this. So again I am telling, for problem solution you need to copy from this right now, because in PDF I will give only the problems, not the solution. Solution clear there. So if I connected these two like that, what will be the connection looks like? See, the connection will be positive terminal of C1. Here it will be positive, 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 positive. This will be negative, 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 negative. So this positive terminal will be connected to negative terminal of C2. And this negative terminal will be connected to positive terminal of C2. So this is C1, this is C2. This is the condition where the charge, potential can be zero. Suppose C1's charge is Q1 and C2's charge is Q2. So after connecting, what will be the potential? Common potential will be what? Total charge by that total capacitance. Clear? So V equal to total charge by total capacitance. Total charge by total capacitance. Total charge by total capacitance. So if I do, I am doing like that. Now tell me, what is the connection? Connection is looks like just a parallel connection. So what is happening here? The total capacitance will be C1 plus C2, and total charge will be what? Total charge will be obviously, that is Q1 minus Q2. Clear? Because that charge will be not be added, because their charge separation will be subtracted already in my previous class when I have started parallel plate capacitor. That time we are having this kind of discussion. So total charge will be therefore V equal to Q1 minus Q2 and by C1 plus C2, because they are connected in parallel combination, C1 plus C2 done. Now V1 is what? V1 is 120 volt. V1 equal to 120 volt and V2 equal to probably 200 volt. If I am not wrong, let's see the question. Yes, V2 is 200 volt. Now common potential is 0 volt, means this V is 0. So 0 equal to Q1 minus Q2 by C1 plus C2. Now there are two things. If the right hand, left hand side is zero, there is two things happening. That is obviously that C1 plus C2 will be infinite because 1 by infinity is equal to 0. So if C1 by C2 is infinite, so that is not possible. Means it having a value, huge value, but not infinity. Because I am taking capacitors which having infinite capability to hold the charge physically, which is not possible. But according to this equation, it should be that C1 plus C2 is infinity. So when I am writing that 0 equal to Q1 minus Q2 by C1 by C2, so that time I need to write that obviously I am considering that C1 plus C2 not equal to infinity. It should be infinity. Mathematically it should be, but physically in terms of physics it is not possible, because I should not have this kind of capacitance in whole world that which can have the capability to hold infinite amount of charge. So that is the first thing. So if they are not infinity, means they are having a huge value but not infinity. If I am doing it like that, so what will be Q1? Q1 will be equal to C1 V1 and Q2 will be equal to C2 V2. So put V equal to C1 V1 minus C2 V2 by obviously C1 plus C2, my so called things. So C1 minus C2. Now what is happening? We know that 0 by something also 0 and 1 by infinity also 0. So I will not take this condition, is not acceptable for me. So what I will take, so that upper numerator part should be equal to 0. So I am taking that is Q1 minus Q2 somehow equal to 0, means C1 V1 minus C2 V2 is equal to 0. See, so from there what I can write, the simple thing remain, that is C1 V1 equal to C2 V2. So C1 by C2 will be equal to V2 by V1, which is equal to 200 by 120. So 10 by 6 probably, 20 by 12 means what? 20 by 12. 5 by 3. So C1 by C2 is equal to, I am having this part. So from here what I can write, that C1 by C2 equal to 5 by 3, or the relation is 3 C1 will be equal to 5 C2. Then and only then, if I am charging it by 120 volt and 200 volt, so the total capacitance after connection will be 0.